Nearly there, Guthrie. Got your final speech for the prosecution already, have you?
Well, I have a few words to say about your ridiculous defense, Rumpole. No. Yes.
Of course, if you... if you really want the High Court bench, I suppose we'll be seeing you starting to do your cases in a different sort of way.
Rumpole?
Yeah.
What exactly do you mean, Ruth?
Oh, come on, Catherine, you know exactly what I mean. Well, you stop trying so hard to win. Yes, you'll probably be adopting the judicial attitude, I suppose, will you?
Will I? Oh, yes, of course. The judicial attitude.
Yes, Mr. Featherstone.
Of course, members of the jury, as prosecuting counsel, I adopt an attitude which is fair, and I hope judicial. The prosecution has to prove its case, otherwise the defense is entitled to succeed. So, if you think the accused did win the money in his bank account at the races, even if he has forgotten the name of the horse, or even the track concerned, then you must acquit him. If you think he was taking those various animal masks to a party at Dr. Bernardo's homes, or if you think, as he says, he needed those heavy tools to put up his do-it-yourself shelving to accommodate his Encyclopedia Britannica, then the prosecution will not have proved its case, and the defendant Higgins is entitled to be acquitted. In all things, we must be judicial. Totally fair, and keep a balanced view. We must judge all things fairly.
What's up with him, Mr. Rumpole? Was he ill or something?
Now, as you realize...
No, he's just suffering from the terrible consequences of love.
Brought to your attention.
No,
here.
No.
Our points